JIRA is the best-selling platform from Atlassian. It is often used with agile teams, but can be used outside of agile project management methods on a number of different projects. JIRA lets you prioritize, assign, track, report, and audit within the platform. You can choose from different pre-made workflows, or you can create your own to fit your project and company needs. JIRA is great for keeping projects on time, improving productivity, and giving an overview of where many projects are within their workflow. Let's walk through setting up a new project. Step 1 is to create the new project. In the top left corner, click the JIRA Home icon. And then in the top right corner, select Create Project. Step 2, choose a workflow template. So there's three main templates you can choose from based on your project management style. There's Scrum, Kanban, and bug tracking. Scrum is for agile teams that work from a backlog, plan and estimate the work sprints, and deliver work on a regular schedule. Kanban is for agile teams that monitor work in a continuous flow, rather than in sprints. They have a focus on managing in-progress work. And bug tracking is for teams that don't need boards and prefer to manage development tasks and bugs in a list view. If you choose either Scrum or Kanban, you will also be prompted to choose a project type. There are two project types, team-managed projects and company-managed projects. Team-managed projects are suited for independent teams who want to control their own working processes and practices in a self-contained space. Company-managed projects are set up and maintained by JIRA admins. This project type is designed for teams who want a standardized way of working across many teams, such as sharing a workflow. For this tutorial, we are going to be choosing a Kanban team-managed project. So your step 3 is going to be setting up your boards. This step is very similar to Trello if you have experience with Trello. You will be creating boards, labeling them, adding, deleting, rearranging the columns, all so that you can fit your workflow process. Step 4 is creating an issue. Issues are the building blocks of your JIRA software project. An issue can represent a story, an epic, a bug, a feature that you want to build out, or any other individual task in your project. Select Boards in the project menu on the left, hover over your columns, and click Add. You can also add larger projects to your roadmap by clicking Roadmap in the project menu. This larger project is called an epic. All you have to do is start typing to name it. You can then add smaller pieces of work to the issue. Just hover over the epic and click Add to add a child issue. The next step after you have everything set up is inviting your team. You gotta have people to work on your projects, so you're gonna navigate to your board or your backlog, and at the top of the screen, select Add People. Very simple. Start moving your work forward. So you have your boards built out, you have your team added, now it's time to get to work. If you're in a Kanban project, you can start tracking your work on a board. To track work items, you move an issue from one column to another as it progresses through your team's workflow. Again, this is very similar to Trello, but JIRA has more integrations and the ability to see a little more big picture with roadmaps and reporting. The best way to see if a new project management tool will work for you and your team is to try it out. JIRA is free for the first 10 users, so jump in and test it. If you'd like to see more about Trello or Asana, check out these videos. If you have any questions or want to see more tutorials, just let us know in the comments.